Mindtree posted the first quarter numbers. Let's see what the management has to say.
It has certainly been a heartening quarter on growth. What is important was it was a very well-rounded growth. All the three industry segments in which we are in grew very well. High-tech, which has been a laggard for the past several quarters, grew 9.5% quarter-on-quarter based on some new wins, strong IP-led revenues, as well as significant increase in business from few large clients. Our travel and hospitality segment grew 13.5% quarter-on-quarter, again on the back of new wins as well as existing customers growing business significantly. So one piece of the growth driver was clearly strong growth in all the industry segments. The second thing, if you look at service lines, I think we had a 37.5% quarter-on-quarter growth in our package application. In the last few quarters, we have seen infrastructure drove our growth, but clearly for the first time, package applications as well as traditional services, which grew 10.7%, have also driven growth. So the other aspect of growth has really been strong service line growth. What is also very good to note is that all our geographies grew. North America had very strong growth, 7% quarter-on-quarter. Asia Pacific had an 8.5% quarter-on-quarter growth. Europe also grew 1.9% quarter-on-quarter growth. Not because market momentum is low, but there we're really rebuilding the team. So overall, it's been a very well-rounded, balanced growth.
Right. Scott, if you can just take us through the deal momentum that you're seeing in the U.S. ISG gave some very positive commentary on deal flow across major geographies, U.S., Europe, and APAC. Are you, seeing discretionary spend also gaining momentum?
Yeah, we're definitely seeing an increase in deal flow. We're seeing a lot of RFPs out there. Especially in the areas of digital. Digital is one of the very hot topics in the market and one of the areas that Mindtree is extremely well positioned for.
Right. Particularly, if you can give us an update on the large deal pipeline that you're seeing.
We're seeing the large deal pipeline increase, but we're also seeing a different large deal pipeline where the deals have sort of been broken into smaller pieces. So there's still large deals in general, but there's the buyers are starting to farm out certain pieces of it to specialty providers. So they'll carve out the infrastructure piece, they'll carve out the digital piece, and they'll roll that all into one big, large deal.
Right.
Maybe just one observation I want to add to Scott's point. I think clearly we are seeing good traction on multi-year, multi-million dollar deals. What is also good to note in quarter one is that a number of Fortune 100 companies chose Mindtree as their lead partner for digital. There's a large consumer products company which chose Mindtree as the lead partner for all their digital properties. There's a large pediatric nutrition company which again chose Mindtree as their lead partner for digital transformation initiatives. So, like Scott said, we're seeing very strong traction in digital transformation initiatives, and Mindtree is certainly very well positioned to leverage on the momentum which is there in the market.
Right. Also on the margins, this quarter we saw headwinds, such as currency and visa costs. What about the next quarter? Are there headwinds that are, likely to bring down margins in the next quarter as well?
Yeah, well, KK can answer part of that, but the visa costs will be behind us because we incurred most of those visa costs in this quarter preparing for the October numbers. So I think, we've certainly incurred some costs there, but at the same time, we've offset that with increases in utilization,
right.
And we'll think that that trend will continue.
Right.
See, I think Scott rightly pointed out what would be the visa costs which will not be there, but we will have the compensation increase we have already announced and rolled out for 85% of our employees, where we give compensation increases between 6 and 10%. That will have about a 1.9% impact on our margins, as well as we are at a stage in utilization where we've reached 73%, and we think we need to add capacity. So we are going to add about 300 to 400 campus recruits as well as enhance capacity in our lateral. Hmm. Both of that will be headwinds, but certainly we anticipate strong growth in Q2. So we would anticipate a very minor drop in margins, because strong growth will offset both these headwinds which are there on the margins in quarter two.
Right. Finally, KK, do you expect the growth to come in the IP businesses well in the next few quarters? And going by the current growth rates, you are well poised to beat the NASSCOM estimate of 13-15%.
See, like I said earlier, we continue to see a very healthy momentum in our conversation with customers, and particularly in areas like digital, where we are very well positioned, we are seeing very positive conversations. So, and we also closed $165 million of contract in quarter one, and this is the fourth quarter where continuously we have had strong contract closures. So with the contract closures, with the visibility we see, we believe FY15 will certainly be better than what we delivered as growth in FY14. And we are very confident that we'll beat the NASSCOM industry estimates of 13-15% in FY15.